is Michelle. This is here at the third or second poster session at San Antonio. And I'm very pleased and proud to show this particular poster, which is about the metastatic trial search. YSC was honored to be a part of this project. We were invited by breastcancertrials.org to participate. And I'm here with Dr. Elly Cohen, who is going to give us a summary of the poster and tell us about metastatic trial search.
Yes, yeah. I'm delighted to be here and to work with Michelle and all our other collaborators. The goal of this project was really to look at another way to increase awareness and access to trials, which is very important for metastatic patients. And it's clear that patients that participate in trials tend to learn about it from their doctors.
So, but I'll be around.
And trust between the doctor and the patient. Allows patients to feel comfortable participating in trials and learn about trials. So our hypothesis is this was could we ever that exists between an advocacy organization and their membership to raise awareness and access to trials. And we were honored to work collaboratively with five breast cancer organizations, including Young Survivor Coalition, breastcancer.org, Living Beyond Breast Cancer, the Metastatic Breast Cancer Network, and Triple Step for the Cure. And together, representatives of each of these organizations designed a screening tool specifically for metastatic breast cancer patients, collecting elements of their history that would enable them to find trials that match that history. We embedded that tool in all of their websites under their own navigation and banner. And one of the most positive outcomes of the experience was that the advocacy organizations really enjoyed collaborating with each other and agreed that they wanted to have a uniform look and feel, despite the fact that the colors were off, because they wanted the message to presented to their members that this is something that was endorsed across advocacy organizations. The information that people put in their information, the information that is sent back, is in the patient-friendly format that was developed for breastcancertrials.org to try to break down the barriers to clinical trials when patients feel overwhelmed by the amount of information. Our goal is to present enough information so that patients feel comfortable raising the issue of trials with their doctors and have some knowledge of trials so that they can engage in an empowering way and share decision making. The results of the study were very, very positive. We had over 13,000 page views, mostly coming from referrals, from buttons and banners that were placed on the advocacy website. First month that we launched, they had to sell their page. So one of the goals that we have in 2017 is to have a more sustained social media campaign that draws awareness to clinical trials and also the ability to access trials through these advocacy organizations. We went to our patients and we sent them to focus groups and surveys to really learn from the patients what we could do that would make this application better. And from the patients, we learned what they really wanted. We adopted the results precisely, so we have a little search box and filters, so if somebody received results, they'll be able to focus only on treatment trials or only on trials for immunotherapy, so that they can really get the information that they want more precisely. So we are very delighted to have several organizations that are joining the collaboration next year, and we look forward to continuing to speak in an advocacy voice together about ways we can enhance the understanding and participation in the trials, and we're doing advanced research today.
Thank you.